Just wait a minute, I'll present my screen. Fine. Now the screen is visible. In the last lecture, we have seen queues, the queue data structure and its operation. Okay. Queue goes with the simple analogy of a day-to-day queue, which we encounter in our daily life, where the people will be standing in a line, and the person at the first position will be served first, and he is going to exit the queue from that position. And if a person wants to get added in the queue, he needs to get added from the end and will be the last one to get served. So unlike stack, this has two ends from which the entry and exit happens, two separate ends for entry and exit. The exiting end called as front, and the adding end or insertion end or entering end is called as rear. So we have gone through all these things, the NQ operation, DQ operation, where by manipulating front and rear, we can very easily manage the queue. Okay, so that's what care you need to take. And I asked you to write a program and submit it as an assignment for implementation of queue. So we'll just briefly go through this in so most of you have done it, but not all. Very nearly half the students did it. I don't know about the rest. So we'll discuss about that, but we'll finish out this first. So we are declaring a size as 5 and items as an array, which will be implementing queue. So we are implementing queue and stack both using arrays. So actually, they are treated as an array in the memory, but logically or virtually we are treating them as a stack or a queue for our better understanding. Okay, otherwise at the memory end they are stored as a array only, and hence they are handled as array in their respective programs. So initial positions of front and rear are placed at -1. They are pointing nowhere, and we are declaring three functions: NQ, DQ, and display. Okay, these functions are called in main one by one, and the actions will be taken place. How? What actions will be taken place? There are three functions which we are dealing with: NQ. NQ means entering an element into a queue, so that element has to be mentioned. Once that element is mentioned, we are just checking whether trailer is equal to size -1. If it is size -1, that means queue is already full, no further elements can be entered into it. If not, there are two possibilities: either it will be the first element to enter, or it will be the second or other element to be inserted. Okay, so if it is the first element, that moment front will be equal to -1, rear will also be equal to -1. So we are initializing front to 0, will be the first element, and rear ++ will again become 0, and an element will be entered at that particular moment. If it is not the first element, we are not going to change front. This part will be skipped, and we are going to directly change the rear. So this is a simple logic behind inserting an element in a queue. Similarly, deleting means either the queue is empty, there are no elements in the queue to be deleted. If it is not, then we are going to just collect that element and increment the front. Okay, front will be incremented. And in case after incrementing front, it exceeds rear, it becomes greater than rear, that means there are no more elements left in the queue to be deleted. So better initialize front and rear again back to -1, so that will come to the initial positions. And this is a simple one, that is a display. Okay, with the for loop, we are displaying all the elements which are right now present in the queue. So this was a discussion in last lecture, and I expect, as you are not raising any doubt, it is clear. We'll go for the further discussion. Now we'll come back to our same discussion once again. This is a queue. This is a queue in which we have few elements. These are the elements which are there. This is a position of front, and this is a position of rear. Okay, so front will be pointing to the zeroth element, that is the first element, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, 13. There are total 13 elements. This 12 is the last subscript. Now, if I want to add some element here, let us say that I am adding 87. Rear will be pointing to this. When I'll add further more elements, 71, rear will be pointing to this. Let us say that we are adding one more, 77, rear will be pointing to this. So at this particular moment, rear is equal to size minus 1. Size is, in this case, size is 13. So it is pointing to the 12th index. That means there are no further elements which can be added in the queue. Queue is full. This is the simple logic behind that. Okay. Now, if I want to insert an element, it is not possible because queue has no space left. If I am going for the now, if I delete the element, let us say that I am deleting 5. What will happen? What will happen? F will come to this position. If I delete 9, F will come to this position. If I delete 4, F will come to this position. So what's happening? With insertion, we are incrementing rear. With deletion, we are incrementing F. But what will be the scenario in this case? I can observe. So just I'll write the inserted element over here. 87, 71, and 77. So right now rear is pointing to this position. Rear is pointing to this position, not to this. Okay. So front is here, rear is here. After deleting these three elements, we have got front at this position. Now, can I insert an element here? Is it possible for me to insert an element? No. What is your queueful condition? Queueful condition is R is equal to size minus 1. Okay. The condition is still true. Condition is still true, and we are not able to insert an element in the queue even if we have space. We have space available in the queue, but it is not possible for me to enter any element in this queue now, because rear is pointing to the last element. This is the problem, or this is the biggest disadvantage of this linear queue, which is, even if we have a space, we are not able to add any elements. It's like we are going to some service station and they are taking only 50 people to be served in a day. So once 50 count is reached, even if they have time, they have availability of services, then they are not going to serve. Okay, they are not going to add any more elements. This will be this kind of scenario. So in this case, even if we have space available over here, it's not possible for us to add any element. This is the biggest disadvantage of this queue. We'll have to wait on this and until we get entire queue empty, because it is not possible to delete from the rear end. Entire queue empty, then we'll again initialize F and R equal to minus 1, and then only the new insertions will be started. This is the problem. Okay. Now, what is the solution on this? That solution we are going to see today. The solution is try to point to the first element after the last element. Okay, what we are doing now, R plus plus. Every time we insert an element, we will do R plus plus. Okay, and if it is the last element, we will make this next part to be pointing to the beginning of the queue, beginning of the array. And if it is not front, if this is not front, that means it is possible for me to include something here. Okay, of course it will be treated as a last element. Then again R plus plus, this is not equal to front, I am going to enter an element over here. Okay, again R plus plus, I am going to enter. Then R plus plus, this R will be equal to F, and I won't be enter to. I will be able to enter the elements over here. Okay, this way, this is the remedy over this. This particular thing is called as a ring buffer or a circular queue. This is called as circular queue. That's what the concept we are going to see today. Circular queue is a linear data structure in which the operations are performed on first in first out basis or last in last out basis, and the last position is connected back to the first position to make a circle. Okay, it is also called as a ring buffer. It will look something like this. So ultimately this is the normal queue of size 8. It can accommodate 8 elements. It can accommodate 8 elements in this way. It is a normal queue only. This is just a logical representation of a circular queue, which is saying that, see here, this is the first element, the zero subscript. First element is entered, so front will be pointing to that. Second, third, fourth, fifth, and rear will be pointing to this. If I am adding some more elements, let us say that 60 I have added, 70 I have added, 80 I have added. So slowly R is going to get incremented. Okay, R will be incremented by 1, normal. Okay, so let us say that 80 is added at this position. Okay, again queue full position is same. Size in this case is 8. So if R is equal to size minus 1, then queue is full. Okay, so the conditions are similar, but what we are trying to do is after R, after the last index, we are going back to the first index. We are going back to the first index. It's a normal queue. So this kind of queue is there. Logic conceptually it is a ring, implementation wise or physically it's a normal queue. Physically, it's a normal queue. Only thing is, after R, we are trying to, after the last index of array, we are trying to access the first index. Okay. What will happen in this case? Now, right now the queue is full. I cannot add any element further. If I am deleting 10, front is going to point here. Right? Making a space at this particular position. Making a space at this particular position, and if I have some more element to be added, R can be incremented to this position, and 90 can be inserted in this case. Are you getting it? So whenever one element is deleted, we are going to make a space for the next element to be entered. Okay, so this is the way this ring buffer or a circular queue works. We'll see the implementation one by one. Let us say that this is your circular queue in which size is coming out to be 8. Okay. Let us try to insert one by one. The initially, of course, the same case. F and R both will be equal to minus 1. Initially, both will be equal to minus 1. They are pointing nowhere in the queue. Nowhere in the queue. Okay. Then I insert one element here. Let us say that I am inserting 12. So, what will be the condition? Are you understanding what I am trying to say here? Is everyone understanding? Please prompt at least. so that I can proceed. Okay. So let us proceed further. So as soon as I enter one element, F and R both will be equal to zero. Both will be pointing to the same element. That element will be the first and last element which is entered in the queue. Okay, both will be pointing to one. Both will be pointing to 12. That is zeroth element. Right. So this will be your normal scenario. The first insertion. What if I am inserting the next element? What if I am inserting a next element? Let us say that this is 12 and this is 15. I am inserting. So F is going to remain unchanged, and rear will be incremented by one. If I am adding few more elements. So simply rear will be incremented by one every time. Okay. So this will be your rear in this case. So this is the same logic which we have implemented in the normal linear queue. Again, I'll add a few more elements over here. So again, rear will be incremented by one, and rear is right now pointing over here. Right. So I am not touching the queueful condition. We are just reaching at this. Now next is I want to delete 12 and 15. I will delete 12 and 15. Okay. So what will be the scenario in that case? If I am deleting these two elements, if I am deleting 12 and if I am deleting 15, what will happen? Front will be incremented by one in both the cases. Okay. Now our queue position will be 20. So these are the elements which are already present. We have not deleted them. We have deleted only the first two elements, and which is repositioning F. This rear will be here only, and F will now be pointing to this position. Okay. F is pointing to this position. And now if I want to insert one more element, let us say that I want to insert 22. I want to insert this element in this case. What will happen? Can I insert it here? Yes, of course I can insert it here. But how we are making, can we increment R plus plus? What it will return me? 8. So 8 is not in the scope of indexing of this array. Okay, 8 is not in the scope of indexing of this array. It must return 0. It must return 0. So how it can return 0? A very simple thing we are doing. Again, I am repeating, whenever we are incrementing in a normal queue, where whenever we are inserting an element, we are incrementing F. Whenever we are inserting one element in a normal queue, we are incrementing R. And whenever we are deleting, we are going to increment F by 1. Same thing here we are doing, but only thing what we want is after the last element, if the rear reaches last element, we want it to access the first element in the next iteration. Okay, so after the last, after 7, it should reach to 0, and then again 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, again it should reach to 0. So very small change we are making out here. Instead of saying R++, we are saying R is equal to R plus 1 mod S. S is the size of array. R is the current position of 1. What do you mean by a mod function? Can anyone answer? What is a mod function? What it is going to return?
It's going to return remainder.
it is going to return the remainder. Yes, absolutely right. Palash, Aditya, Ishant, you people are absolutely right. It is going to return the remainder. Division operation has two results. Unlike plus, minus, and multiplication, this has two results. One is quotient, another is remainder. Okay. When we perform a normal division operation, we are talking about only quotient in the understanding that remainder will always be zero. But if you want to explicitly have a remainder, then we use a mod function. So let us see that how this function works. Right now, in this current position of our queue, this is 7 plus 1 mod, whole mod, size 8. Okay, so 8 mod 8, what it is going to return? 0. Okay, so has it returned the position at which we can insert an element? Yes, definitely. Let us say that 22 is inserted at this position. Now R is pointing to this position, not this. Are you understanding? Instead of R++, what we are doing, R plus 1 mod size. So it is going to return me the intended position, the position which I want to be accessed next. And this formula will be true for every other element also. Let us say that I am inserting element 50. Try to insert element 50. Of course, R++ we are going to do. We are going to increment R. But right now, along with this only, in this position, at this position, if I want to insert R, what can I do is, what is R? Currently 0. 0 plus 1, whole mod 5. Whole mod 8. So it will be 1 by 8. 1 divided by 8, remainder will be 1. Is it the position at which the R is going to point to insert 50? Right. So this way we can insert an element in the queue in a circular fashion. Even if after reaching the last index, we can move to the next index, what will be the terminating condition? Now, if I want to insert, let us say that I wish to insert element 4. Okay, this formula is going to return 2. Okay, but can I insert at 2? No, because F is already pointing to that position. So every time after adding R, we are going to check whether R is equal to F. We are going to check whether R is equal to F. So every time, sorry for the interruption, I was a little distracted. So every time we are going to convert, check whether R is equal to F or not. And if it is, then we are not going to insert an element. That is a queueful condition. So this is your queueful condition. R is equal to F is your queueful condition. Okay. So this way we are going to check out or we are going to insert an element. Similar formula I can apply for deletion. If I am deleting an element, let us say that I am deleting this element, I can, instead of saying F++, simply we can say F plus 1 again mod S. Let us say that we are trying to delete this element 2. F is increment, how F will be incremented now? F is 2 plus 1 mod 8. It is going to get me 3 by 8, 3 mod 8, which is returning me 3. So is it the position at which F will be pointing once 20 is deleted? Right? So every time, now in this circular queue, instead of going for an incremental operation, we'll be going for only a mod operation, which will return me the correct position. Even if I'm reaching to the last element, it will take me back to the first element. Right? So this is the way we handle a circular queue. Okay. So just I'll be back in 2 minutes. You can just go through this slide till now. By that time, I'll be So okay, I'm back. So is it clear how we are handling a circular queue? This prompt, yes or no? Fine. This is a simple logic behind that. If I just wish to go for a algorithm, we are going to insert and delete the elements in this way only. The logic is very simple. Just if I'm trying to insert an element, first we are going to check whether the queue is full or not. So the condition is either rear is equal to size minus one and front is equal to zero, or front is equal to rear plus one. Either condition is there, queue is full, we are not going to do anything. If it is not, then we are going to apply this formula. Okay, and in deletion, okay, by mistake I have written here in queue, it should be deletion. It should be DQ operation. Okay, in DQ operation, we are changing front. In DQ operation, we are changing front. Okay, so this is the simple one which you have already implemented. So, and I'll not go in the details of this. Fine. One more thing which I want you to know is priority queue. Priority queue is a special type of queue in which the elements in the queue are assigned with a priority. So that the order in which they are supposed to be deleted or served will be defined. That means if I have a queue to be defined, let us say that it has four elements. This is job number. It will be also associated with its priority. So we need to assign a priority. So in this case, the priority will be more important. The element which is having higher priority or the job which is having higher priority will be executed first. Okay. So we are assigning or processing in this the element which has higher priority is processed before any element of lower priority. Okay, and if two elements are having same priority, are processed according to the order in which they are added in the queue. So this we are not going to implement. It's just for your knowledge. There is something called as priority queue, which is in existence. It is specially, as we have already discussed, the queue is serving the purpose of your job scheduling or resource scheduling. So that time, if a higher priority job, let us say that you are accessing a computer, and by virtue the power is off and the computer has to be shut down, so at that time it will not function, it will not operate on your the jobs which you are performing, the processes which you are performing, but it will first shut down the PC and save the temporary data, so that next time whenever it will boot the machine, you are going to get that data back. So that will be its priority. So it is the highest priority job which will be converted. So every time that in a queue, that job will be given a higher priority. So this is a priority queue. We are not going to implement that, just to make you people understand. So this is all about the queues. This data structure is having no application which can be directly implemented, as we did in the case of your stacks. In stacks, we have found the postfix to prefix expression, or prefix to postfix expression. So this is not doing anything like that, but this is just to be known for this purpose. And in the last two lectures, we have implemented stack and queues using arrays. Another data structure, the array is very useful data structure, which is abstract data type and can be used to go for implementation of stacks and queues and many other data types and data structures. But here in this case, we are also going to see one more data structure called as linked list from the next lecture. Okay, so right now, now I want all you people to put your cameras on and mics on. Put your cameras on and mics on. I wish to discuss some other issue for next 10 minutes. So put your mics on and cameras on and be open for discussion. Be clear with whatever you are looking for. I want everyone to keep your these things on. Everyone, those who will not make it on within 2 minutes, I am going to remove him or her from the meeting. It's very clear. I'll just give you 2 more minutes. In the meeting time, if it is 10:11 and your camera is not on, I am going to remove you. I don't have a webcam on my PC. Dhaval. Okay. Okay. Danish. Okay. No webcam. So how come you don't have a webcam? Are you accessing PCs? Divesh, you should buy a webcam, because shortly we'll be going for different seminars and all, so it will be difficult for you. Fine. If someone is getting too many noises, then they can put their mic off, and whenever they are needed, they can make it on. Fine. Now my few questions you please answer. From past 2-3 weeks, what I started is I will give at least one lecture in a week in a recorded fashion, and other two I'll take in a live fashion. So let me know what is comfortable form of learning for you people. Is it online lectures are comfortable for you, or you prefer the recorded lectures, or a blended mode will be okay for you, like half an hour recorded lecture and half an hour discussion? So I just want to have a clear discussion from you, because this subject is of course little tough, and if you are not practicing it at your places, after the lectures, it will be difficult for you to understand, because we have covered a lot of portion of C. In my understanding, I am understanding that yes, you have understood C language, and now I am just concentrating on algorithms. I am not concentrating on how those algorithms are written in a C language. In understanding that, you are comfortable with that. But now it's high time to let me understand that at what level you are, and do you want anything to be repeated from my side, or you are not understanding, or you want some time to brush up all those things. So all these things I want to know from your side. So you can open up and tell me what are the difficulties you are finding. Are you really understanding the subject or not? It's your time. Anyone can speak. It's not the CR. It is you who is learning. And when we had a talk with some parents, then so the parents were saying that if they are doing the lectures just for sake of attending them, they are not attentive, they are not concentrating. Of course, it is not true for all. Few parents have admitted that their words are very serious, but few people are saying that, or few parents are saying that they'll just put the mic and videos off and they'll be doing whatever they want. So this is not for my benefit. Even if 10 or 8-10 people are listening to me, it's enough for me. Whatever efforts I am putting, it's enough for me. It is fruitful even if 10 people of you are understanding that. But other 50, they are wasting their time. If they are not understanding, they should ask me. I am happy few of your classmates will be continuously in my touch. They'll be sometimes asking me the doubt at night, 11 o'clock or 12 o'clock. I welcome those also. At that time also, I entertain. It's not like I don't entertain them. I am happy that they are so involved in studies. But many a times, I am not able to understand others are comfortable with it or not. So it's up to you. Now, you please discuss what mode you prefer. Yes. Yes, you can tell me. Tell me openly. Yes, Palash, you can start.
Sir, I think a blended mode will be good.
Blended mode in the sense half an hour recorded lecture and then half an hour discussion on that, or the similar way we are doing that one lecture will be recorded and the next lecture will be live.
Yes, sir. One lecture recorded one and other two lectures live lectures.
Okay. What is the opinion about of other people? Please speak. Be open. अच्छा पलाश, ये बैकग्राउंड तुमने ब्लर कैसे किया रे? ये क्या उसका एक्सटेंशन है क्या?
सर उधर ऑप्शन आते हैं ना, जैसे ज्वाइन करने के पहले ऑप्शन आते हैं।
ज्वाइन करने से पहले ऑप्शन आता है?
यस सर।
मुझे तो नहीं दिखाया यार कभी। कहाँ पे आता है?
सर मुझे आज ही दिखाएंगे।
इसने भी किया है शायद अपना
को अपडेट हुआ है
सर, जो रिकॉर्डिंग जहां से चालू करते हैं वहीं पे ऑप्शन आया है।
चलो मैं भी कोशिश करता हूँ क्योंकि हर बार बैकग्राउंड देखना पड़ता कि कहाँ हम लोग बैठे हुए हैं। तो दिस ब्लरिंग ऑप्शन इज मच बेटर। यू मोस्ट ऑफ यू आर यूजिंग इट। अनीश इज आल्सो यूजिंग इट आई गेस, है ना? Okay, yes, let me try that, how it is happening. But yes, you people can tell. ये समझ में आ रहा है कि सब्जेक्ट, ये सीधी सी बात पे जाते हैं हम लोग, सीधे बात पे जाते हैं, क्योंकि आर वी वेस्टिंग अवर टाइम और इज इट गेटिंग इन्वेस्टेड?
सर व्हाट आई थिंक इज दैट दिस सब्जेक्ट रिक्वायर्ड प्रैक्टिस एज वेल अपार्ट फ्रॉम द inputs which you are giving to us, and the other thing which we need to do is the practice. we need to practice much coding and solve other problems. Then only we will get to know this language and will be comfortable with it.
That is my opinion. Are the people doing it or not? That's my question. Are the people, the students, are doing it or not? You please be open. ये सभी लोग को मैं ओपन भी पूछ रहा हूँ क्योंकि ठीक है ऑनलाइन का ऑनलाइन टीचिंग इज नॉट एज इफेक्टिव एज द फिजिकल टीचिंग बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली वी आर इन अ मोड एंड यस्टरडे ओनली द अनबॉक 5 डायरेक्शंस हैव कम यू माइट हैव रेड द न्यूज दैट दे आर स्टिल इंसिस्टिंग ऑन ऑनलाइन लर्निंग देन गैदरिंग मेनी पीपल इन द क्लास ठीक है फिलहाल तो एक दो महीने और वही चलेगा तो दैट इज द ओनली थिंग विच वी आर लेफ्ट विथ तो इस सूरत में मुझे लगता है कि आप लोग ओपन अप रहेंगे आप लोग बताएंगे क्योंकि आई थिंक सी आर एंड एस आर सी हैड अ मीटिंग विद कुटेसर एंड दे इंसिस्टेड ऑन रिकॉर्डेड लेक्चर सो इज इट द ओनली मोड यू आर प्रेफरिंग Palash is saying that he wished to go for a blended one. लेकिन बाकी भी लोग कुछ बोलो, बाकी लोग भी बोलो. Yes, sir.
हाँ, Aaron, बोल, बोल.
बोले, बोले, sir, जितने बोले, बोले.
Sir, हमने कुछ दिन पहले एक meeting रखी थी सबके students की. उसमें constructively एक यही decision था सबका कि अगर समझो किसी का एक दिन miss हो जाता है, तो उसके आगे की जो lectures है, unless until new topic नहीं start होता, वो पूरा blank जाता है.
अच्छा
तो अगर रिकॉर्डेड लेक्चर्स भी मिल गए लाइव लेक्चर्स के या फिर अगर रिकॉर्डेड लेक्चर रहा एंड देन उसका डिस्कशन रहा तो वो काफी ज्यादा इफेक्टिव रहेगा कंपेयर्ड टू ओनली लाइव लेक्चर्स
ओके हां तो ये जो बात कर रहे हो कि कोई अगर मिस कर देता है तो आई ऑलरेडी मेड अ ऑप्शन ओपन दैट यू प्लीज गिव मी अ सेंड मी अ मैसेज आई विल गिव द लिंक ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर टू दैट पर्सन आई एम डूइंग दैट So if you wish that every lecture need to be posted, then I'll post every lecture in Moodle. So,
yes, वो एक decision था. All lectures should be posted. Like if someone didn't get it or for any reason or network problem anything, he or she can access it easily.
Yeah, that even I can understand because a live lecture eats a lot of your bandwidth, a lot of your data for. Being live for 1 hour is, of course, consumes, I guess, more than 400 MB. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so this is okay that 100 or 200 MBs we can consume through this. Okay, I'll post every lectures link on a daily basis on Moodle. If you are missing it because of some reason, then definitely you can find it there. And like recorded lecture of course I am trying to give one at least one recorded lecture in every week so one or two I'll make so at least once in a week or twice in a week we should meet what I guess to recorded lecture mein aap comfortable ho main ye janna chahta hu agar aap comfortable hai to it is I'll go for more and more recorded lectures in a even better way, whatever right now I'm doing. और ये subject के बारे में क्या opinion है? Subject समझ रहा है या नहीं समझ रहा है? चैतन्य आप हो ना इसके CR, इस class के CR. हाँ तो मैं request करता हूँ कि आप एक unofficial पूरे class का एक meeting लो. हो सकता है कि direct ये बच्चे मुझसे नहीं बात कर पाए. और ये चीजें समझ रही है नहीं समझ रही है या कौन सी चीजें वो लोग चाहते हैं कि रिपीट करे उसके बारे में थोड़ी इंफॉर्मेशन पूछो और आप परसों तक के अगर मुझे बता पाए कि सर ये टॉपिक्स थोड़े रिपीट करने पड़ेंगे या फिर ये डिफिकल्टीज ऑन एन एवरेज बच्चों को जा रही है आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट 8-10-15 पीपल हु आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग द सब्जेक्ट वेल और डूइंग बाय देमसेल्फ बट आई विश एवरीवन टू बी अंडरस्टैंडिंग एट अ एवरेज लेवल मिनिमम बेरली मिनिमम लेवल पे समझे तो आप वो थोड़ा जानने की कोशिश करो और किनको क्या प्रॉब्लम्स आ रहे वो मुझे बताओ आप लोग
ठीक है ना ओके
ठीक है हाँ तो सबके लिए बेहतर रहेगा दोज हु आर नॉट एबल टू स्पीक आर एटलीस्ट लिसनिंग टू मी सो आई वॉन्ट यू पीपल टू बी ओपन इन लर्निंग द सब्जेक्ट और मेरी सिंसियर रिक्वेस्ट रहेगी जब हम लोग लेक्चर्स आपके लेते हैं तो आप कहीं आपको हमारे एफर्ट्स में कमी नजर आ रही है क्या, आप ये भी बता सकते हो कि नहीं सर आप इतने एफर्ट नहीं ले रहे हो तो हम लोग क्यों एफर्ट लेंगे इतने, इज इट अ काइंड ऑफ ओपिनियन इफ यू आर कैरिंग, देन मेक दैट क्लियर ऑल्सो. आर यू फाइंडिंग एनी लैग इन अवर एफर्ट्स? यस, हमारे एफर्ट्स की कम लग रहे हैं, यस और नो, कुछ तो बोलो, क्योंकि हमें एफर्ट लेने पड़ते हैं, हमें रिकॉर्ड करने पड़ते हैं लेक्चर्स, रात रात को पीपीटीज बनानी पड़ती है, एनिमेटेड पीपीटीज बनानी पड़ती है ताकि आपको बेहतर तरीके से समझ में आए. हम हमारी कोशिश कर रहे हैं, हमारे लिए भी ये चीज़ नहीं है, आपके लिए भी नहीं है, है ना. वी ऑल इन दिस सिचुएशन फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, एंटायर वर्ल्ड इज इन दिस सिचुएशन फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम. तो वॉट एवर हमारी तरफ से कुछ कमियाँ रह सकती है तो आप डेफिनेटली हमको बता सकते हैं, है ना. तो कंस्ट्रक्टिवली सब लोग आपके क्लास मीटिंग में थोड़ा ये करो, मैं भी कुछ रिकॉर्डिंग और कुछ ब्लेंडेड मोड में लेने की कोशिश करूंगा. और प्लीज फॉर द अटेंडेंस से ज्वाइन मत होइए आप मीटिंग, ठीक है ना. आप अटेंटिव रहने के लिए या कुछ समझने के लिए ज्वाइन होइए, ऐसा नहीं है कि बस 9:30 बजे उठ गए और उठते बराबर मीटिंग ज्वाइन कर लिया और अपना काम करते बैठे. सम पीपल मे डू दैट because many a times I call the names and they don't respond because they have just joined the meeting and left. So isme mera koi nuksan nahi hai, nuksan aapka hone wala hai kahin na kahin, because there is a possibility that this month onwards you are going to get evaluated for whatever we have learned, and mind well, whatever assignments you have till date submitted may be through Canvas or may it be through Moodle, may it be a quiz, an assignment, maybe a program, everything is getting calculated, everything is recorded, and it is going to comprise your 10 marks of internal. Har ek iska koi 1/4, koi half, koi 1 mark ka weightage rahega wo pure 10 mein. If you have missed that means you have missed those marks, that component of 10 marks. Ye bhi dhyan mein rakho. मैंने अगर बोला है कि इसका असाइनमेंट सबमिट करो, उसका असाइनमेंट सबमिट करो, तो बी सीरियस इन सबमिटिंग दोस, यू आर गोइंग टू लूज द मार्क्स, एंड दिस इज वेरी ऑन रिकॉर्ड थिंग, सो देयर इज नो स्कोप ऑफ एन इंप्रेशन, ठीक है ना. तो ये चीज भी आपने ध्यान में रखनी है. तो खैर ठीक है, आई एम नॉट फाइंडिंग यू पीपल रेजिंग मेनी इशूज, बट स्टिल चैतन्य यू प्लीज कंडक्ट द मीटिंग.
Yes, sir.
In fix, pre, post, fix. Okay, someone is asking that. Yes, Aditya, right. We'll once with the program. Repeat it once with the program. Fine, we will do it. You just please, miss. That's what I'm saying. This is good, Aditya. You please, all of you discuss and list out all the things. We will repeat. We have time. We have time. We are already in the fourth unit of your syllabus. I haven't seen the syllabus. We were just learning, and now I came to know that we are in the fourth unit of our syllabus. So we have good time. We can go back and repeat anything. So please discuss in your class and come up with a proper list, which need to be repeated. Okay, I'll repeat all these things in the next week. We can go for repetition only, or I go for recorded lectures. Which you can see repeatedly. है ना? ये करेंगे हम लोग. कोई हर्ज नहीं. और दूसरी चीज, प्रैक्टिकल्स की भी कुछ दिक्कतें हैं तो आप मुझे जरूर बताएं, क्योंकि आई एम राइट नाउ नॉट कंडक्टिंग प्रैक्टिकल्स, सो फ्रॉम नेक्स्ट वीक ऑनवर्ड्स आई विल कंडक्ट द प्रैक्टिकल, आई विल कम विथ यू इन द प्रैक्टिकल. ठाकरे सर इज लुकिंग फॉर दैट, सो इफ यू हैव एनी डिफिकल्टीज इन प्रैक्टिकल्स और नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग हाउ टू कोप अप विद दैट, हाउ टू परफॉर्म, how to submit, because I have seen the submission, it is quite well understood by you people how to submit and all, but it is if you have some algorithm and flowchart problem, Chirag, yes, so you, that's good. So you just list out the theory problems and practical problems, fine. We'll discuss all these things, so we'll try to just remove all those anxieties and smooth out the subjects. Because now it is clear that for a few more days still we are going for online. It is not possible for us to meet till I think end of November or probably December. they are not going to permit us to meet physically. So this will be the only thing which we have. Sir, can we use compilers during class to compile the problems? Yes, miss, you want me to get the programs executed, Mansi?
Yes, sir, because since we are using different online compilers, there is a problem because every compiler uses different sort of proxy.
Okay. I'll go for one. I'll just find out which will one at least which will support most of the things. See, these online compilers are actually failing in managing pointers. क्योंकि उनका physical memory नहीं होता ना, तो pointers में बड़ी दिक्कत देते हैं. तो I'll find out some which will give me a virtual scenario that I'll use. Okay, don't worry. We can go for those kind of live things. For one or two lectures, I've done that. Now onwards, I'll also again do that. So for live execution. So these kind of problems, please discuss among yourselves and Chaitanya, get them listed and please post it to me so that we will take the remedial actions over that. And please feel free to post me any of your problems at a personal level. If you are not understanding, that is okay for me. I am not there for the entire class. I am there for every student separately. Fine. Everyone can approach me. Okay. So let's hope that you'll be getting me the doubts and I'll be able to clear all the things. Fine. So this is all from my side. I guess your next link might have arrived. So you can leave the meeting. Thank you very much.